This Boeing 757 is on a collision course with a business jet as it attempts to land in Topeka, Kansas.
Traffic on runway. Traffic on runway.
An alert inside the cockpit leads to a go-around, an aviation term when a pilot aborts a landing.
Unfortunately, there's too many and a lot of close calls, but you could also see just the slightest interruption, a little variation, and things can go wrong very quickly.
But this modified jet isn't carrying paying customers. It's performing tests for Honeywell's new anti-collision software.
Seconds matter, and what we're providing the pilot with this technology is more time to get the alert, and process to understand what's happening, and then make the right decision.
In January of 2025, an Army Black Hawk helicopter and an American Airlines jet collided as the airliner was on final approach to Washington's Reagan National Airport. The crash killed all 67 people on board the two aircraft. It was the worst U.S. airline crash since 2001. Experts and data suggest that these situations are still very rare, but concerns are growing as the airspace gets more congested.
The amount of airline traffic has increased exponentially over the last few years. So you have more traffic congestion, you're going to get more reported close calls.
In February, a Southwest 737 was landing at Chicago Midway Airport when the pilots noticed a business jet crossing the runway. The Southwest jet pulled up just seconds before colliding with it.
They're very, very rare, but obviously they're something that are concerning.
The National Transportation Safety Board and other safety experts have urged more advanced cockpit alerts for pilots to avoid such incidents.
Seconds count when you're operating near the runway, and the sooner you can let the pilots know of a potential serious situation, the better.
CNBC boarded a flight with Honeywell to recreate real-life scenarios like Southwest's to demo how technology can give pilots more reaction time to avoid close calls. Every day in the United States, there are 44,000 flights carrying 3 million travelers. Serious accidents and fatal crashes are rare. But in 2023, the aviation industry saw dozens of near misses of commercial airliners. Some so close, reports describe them as skin to skin. Many of them were at or near airports.
It might be over half of the mid-air collisions that have occurred over the past couple of decades have occurred in the traffic pattern or in or around an airport.
The air traffic controller shortage and outdated technology in control towers are also adding to concerns about possible collisions. So far in 2025, the FAA says there's been more than 1,300 runway incursions, three of them determined to be the most severe category, a serious incident in which a collision was avoided.
Fortunately, commercial airlines are required to have traffic alerting and collision avoidance systems installed, specifically TCAS.
Since 1991, all U.S. commercial passenger planes have been equipped with TCAS. Today, these systems are made by aerospace companies like Collins Aerospace and Honeywell.
Every system's got to have some resiliency built in for human error, and one of the human errors could be you level off at an incorrect altitude. And so if ATC doesn't catch it immediately, the TCAS is there as an additional technology piece that intervenes and does a really, really good job.
TCAS tracks nearby aircraft using transponders that talk back and forth to each other. It issues pilots a traffic advisory if another plane gets close, and then a resolution advisory if it's critical to get out of the way. The RA audibly tells pilots to climb or descend to avoid collision, but there are limitations.
TCAS eliminates the alerts below 1,000 feet because there's just so many other airplanes there that it will cause the pilot to do something even though that other airplane isn't on a collision, it's just landing on a parallel runway. As aircraft get closer to the airports, where there are other airplanes that are also flying low to the ground, attempting to land, that's the most dangerous spot to have a collision occur.
So today we've got TCAS, but that's only for airborne. There's no alerts for collision on the runway.
We're in Topeka, Kansas, where we're about to see a demo from Honeywell of their anti-collision technology. There's a business jet out on the runway here, and they're about to bring a 757 and show us how their software works when there's another plane on the runway that they're about to land on.
On runway 19.
We flew in the cockpit of Honeywell 757 as it tested its new surface alert software, Surf A. The company recreated actual close calls to show real-life scenarios.
The Austin incident in February 2023, where aircraft was coming into land, it was early in the morning, very low visibility, and another aircraft was cleared to take off, but was still on the runway. And so aircraft coming into land, another aircraft on the runway. In that situation, we would provide a 30-second additional alert to the pilot that traffic is on the runway. So they have more time to go around.
Sometimes on these approaches, you can barely see one approach light leading you to the runway until finally you see the threshold and land. And by then, it's too late if there's an airplane already on the threshold.
We've tried to improve the technology so that the alerts occur further away from the runway, so that if you know there's an aircraft on the runway, you're not having to make that decision very low to the ground. You see that that's happening, you know, 1,000 feet, 2,000 feet above the ground. That gives the pilots more time to maneuver the aircraft and avoid, you know, landing with somebody on the runway.
Honeywell expects FAA approval of Surf A next year. Once approved, airlines can opt to purchase it as an additional feature to its other runway safety products already on the market.
Smart X, also known as Smart Runway, Smart Landing, or RAS, Runway Awareness Alerting System, has actually been around since 2008. Alaska Airlines was our first U.S. airline that equipped with this software upgrade to EGBWS. Most recently, we announced the Southwest Airlines. All of their 737s now have this on board, their aircraft as well.
Long landing, long landing.
Smart X alerts pilots if flaps are not set correctly, the runway is too short, or if they try to take off or land on a taxiway. If they're coming in too high or too fast, among a few other alerts.
It's very effective at ensuring our pilots are aware where they are on the airport. So that does a really good job of preventing inadvertent runway incursions while taxiing.
This software is not required by the FAA, but some airlines opt in for the additional layer of safety.
The FAA creates what they consider the minimum standard, and we decide to go above and beyond that. But like anything in aviation to improve safety, we try to add extra layers so that when there's a Swiss cheese hole because our policies and procedures didn't trap the error, we have a technology substitute in the background that can, you know, back up the pilots, and that just makes the airspace system safer for everybody.
Each individual carrier makes additional decisions based on their unique operating environment, aircraft, where they operate. And for us, it seemed like an obvious choice. We fly roughly 4,500 flights a day. We do a lot of shorter flights. We're up and down a lot. This seemed like a technology that would add an additional layer of protection.
Smart X, the runway awareness suite, those features are mostly mandated for new airplanes. So all the OEMs, Boeing, Airbus, they're all integrating that suite of capabilities into new airplanes, but we're also targeting the retrofit airplanes, not just the newly manufactured airplanes.
Since some of these features are not required, it does come with additional costs to the airline.
When you get an aircraft from Boeing or from Airbus, it's like when you purchase your car, you have all sorts of options.
While Honeywell would not disclose the exact price of the new systems, experts predict the software will cost a few million dollars, depending on the size of an airline's fleet.
I want to say $20 to $30 million, somewhere in that range. But any additional technology that may provide further layer of protection, we're certainly interested in. It is cheaper than an accident.
As drones, unmanned aircraft, and even more commercial flights fill the airspace, more technology is critical, as experts say there is still room for improvement.
With Surf A, that is ADS-B in-based technology. It is GPS-based. It has a better accuracy than the TCAS transponder.
In 2020, the FAA mandated that most aircraft in the national airspace be equipped with ADS-B out, shifting from ground-based radar to satellite-derived positioning for improved accuracy.
The FAA is now developing something called ACAS-X, and that will use additional information. So you can use all this surveillance data, antennas on the ground, satellites, air traffic control data, as well as the transponder data to provide a better, more fuller, more accurate picture of the collision threats out there.
It is at the point, I think, where more airlines are seeing, you know, nearer and nearer misses and are hopefully choosing to equip with this, put it in their budget, and get ready for adoption.
And that's why we continue as an industry to try to find even better technology out there and enhancements to the current technology to keep this from ever happening. And I mean, we're going to try to get as close to zero probability as we can.